Welcome to the shop, everybody. It's a Saturday. It's a sunny Saturday. The big door's open, so the sun's in my eyes. I can't really see what I'm doing, but everything that's important is behind me. Now, we've been working on an Orenda turbojet engine for a Sabre. I haven't been filming it because I just posted a series of videos working on the same type of engine, the Orenda 14. The Orenda 10 looks identical. Slight differences. It's a bit of an earlier model. Makes almost the same power. Anyway, let's see. The story was, there was a little bit of FOD damage to the compressor. So we blended them all in place. All the blades we blended in place, made it okay. Then we looked at the stators. And a lot of them were messed up. Nicked, hacked, whatever. And if there's a nick near the base of the blade, maybe I'll show you one later, it's unsafe. So we decided to take all the stators, use the same cases that came off the original engine, but take the stators out of this engine, our donor engine. This is the platform that mounts it to the case of the engine, so it's outer, and this is the leading edge. Let's see if I can get in there. Right at the base of support, right next to it, there is what we would call a very large stress concentration, a nick. You see that? Can you see that? That's not fixable. That's too close to the base. Anything in the bottom third is rejected. But look at that. A lot of the blades look like that. This is garbage, unfortunately. If you blended that, you would narrow the base and it would wobble and eventually snap off and cause all kinds of bad damage. And then, strangely enough, this midframe here, which we'll get to in a second, but the paint was all peeling off. So I needed to paint it for corrosion protection. Now, in order to get the midframe off right here, you've got to take the front frame off. You got to turn it this way, take the front frame off, remove the compressor rotor, all that. It's a lot of work. Anyway, when I had it this way and I took the front frame off, I was shocked to discover what I discovered. And I've talked to the owner of the engine and he said it's okay to show you this footage. So enjoy this. This is part of what I found on that shocking day. Today, we took the front frame off. We undid all the bolts and pulled it off. And much to my amazement, we found this. There are loose pieces of something that have been thrashing around in here for a long time, beating the hell out of the track for the balance weights. But there are a few of these things here. They're all beaten up, so you can't really tell what they are. But they look a lot like, these are balance weights that are in place, and the engine rotates this way. So the leading edge of them has been really smashed and eroded. And there's another one over there. I don't know if these have actually moved along or if that's where they were put. It looks like they've moved along. The area where the balance weights are put in, let's see if we can even find it. There's usually a gap in one of these ridges. Could have been here. It's hard to say because of all the there's something there, but that doesn't look big enough. It's hard to tell. Anyway, there's also, here's a little piece. This piece here is about the size of something that could have got by this seal here. Not much of a seal, more of a fence. There's a few places where it's really beaten up. Could have got through there, and it could have caused the small amounts of FOD all the way through the compressor that we found. The reason I think these are balance weights is because you can almost see the pattern of dimples on them, like that pattern there. There's also one stuck in the front frame up here. And there it is there. It looks a lot like the balance weights that are still in their track. So the basics are, there's a lot of erosion and beating up, but no real damage in here. A lot of debris we can clean up. There's no effect on the seal there. Looks okay. Even this this ridge here. Looks all right. And here we've got a lot of damage to the compressor rotor disc. And so we have three options. Let's go through that. I think we have four options. Hang on. Okay, the first option is to do nothing, because this has been running for quite some time, and obviously it was satisfactory. With these things changing position at all times, they would be in different places, different times the engine was run. And if it wasn't vibrating that much, then taking these out would make it vibrate even less than it was, and what the heck, we could do that. That's the cheapest option. We could just run it the way it is. I don't recommend that, but it's up to you. Second option is there's a tool that we're going to use it keys onto this thread, pushes against this shaft, and it pulls the top two, these two discs out, these two, and we can replace them. We can actually replace just the top one. So we'll reblade it, and then we'll rebalance the compressor, put it together. That would be the second option. The third option is to take that compressor rotor. This is a type 10 right there. It's got no FOD and no real wear or damage. We could put that one into the engine. And of course we'd check the balance of that thing. That's the third option. What's the fourth option? I guess there are three options. Okay, so, but this is what we're looking at, just to give you a better view of things. A lot of smashing. There's another one down in there. Not any catastrophic damage, but I think that the disc itself has some features that are worrisome. Although it does look like it's been doing this for years. And like a couple of people have said, you'd think that these weights would just find a spot and just stick in the same space from centrifugal force when the engine's running. There's no shock loading in a circumferential way. So I don't know why they did all this thrashing, but nonetheless, this is what we're dealing with. It's right here. So this is just the best way I could show you what has happened to the engine without exceeding the limits of emailing pictures and that and whatever. And if a picture's worth 1,000 words, maybe a video's worth 10,000. Anyway, it's all fixable. And this is what it's supposed to look like. That is a good undamaged front of the stage one disc. And there's the balance weights right there. Just in case you were wondering, that's what it's supposed to look like. So far, the front bearing looks fantastic. We're gonna be reusing it. These bits did not get into anywhere near the bearing, but I do believe that the slight FOD on the compressor was caused by a very small piece of one of these weights. Anyway, there we go. That's what we're looking at. Now, in order to paint the midframe, it's mainly for corrosion protection. And I asked the owner when I was at Oshkosh, I said, "So what color do you want?" He goes, "What do you mean?" I said, "Well, the stock color looks like it's beige or gray or sometimes browny. It's like if you drank a vanilla milkshake and threw up, that's the color. It's really not that attractive." So I thought, how about something like titanium silver or something like that? So anyway, this is, what is it? It's called platinum metallic charcoal, and it's awesome. It's super heavy duty paint. It's actually automotive paint, but it's good for 550 degrees Fahrenheit because we've checked it with a heat gun and a propane torch. It's awesome. And I think it just turned out fantastic. Let's take a little bit of a closer look at that. It's just beautiful. Okay, let's move in on this. This is the stock color. Very uninspiring. Ho-hum. And this one's in pretty good shape. It's a beige yuck. So we've got black. Semi-gloss black, semi-gloss black, which doesn't look too bad. We've got high heat silver, which doesn't look too bad. Separated by yuck, it's like puke. It's a disgusting color. On the industrial engines, it's kind of a cream, but this is a grayish, brownish, dull drab, drull and dab, yuck. Anyway, look at this. Oh, it's fantastic. I think this engine's gonna look cool. Custom colors available. Just that it takes a week or so to get the engine apart to get to this. And there are a few drips in there, because I painted it. But they won't be noticed when the whole engine is put together. I think it looks fab, don't you? Just amazing. Platinum metallic charcoal. So now the plan is we are going to replace the entire compressor rotor with this one. This is undamaged, a little bit dirty and stained, but we're gonna clean it up, use the entire rotor because it has intact, undamaged blades. We're gonna use all the stators, but use the original cases because they're slightly different. Painted midframe. We're gonna throw it all back together and it's gonna be one very, very happy Sabre Jet engine. I like it. It's gonna be great. It's gonna be fantastic. This is also a reminder to all of us, to me and you and all of us working on turbojet engines, that they're not designed to be fixed, they're designed to be overhauled, which means they come in after a certain service interval, they get completely disassembled, worked over, recoded, inspected, replaced, whatever, and put back together so it's as new when it goes out for service. Because they do a hard job, they do a tough job, they're highly stressed, and it's not a good idea if one thing has a problem to send it to the shop and say, just do that. Because we found the massive damage to the compressor rotor in this engine only because there was flaking paint on the midframe and I was gonna repaint it. The original plan was not to totally disassemble it, and that's not the best plan. The best plan is after 1,000 hours or the specified interval in your owner's manual or the service overhaul manual of the engine, whichever different engine it is, it'll say after this many hours it needs to be overhauled, and that means everything. It's a good idea. It's a little bit more expensive, but it is safer. And safety is number one. And I'm gonna have great confidence in this engine. We're gonna go through every one of the bearings and all the systems and all the bits and pieces. And it will be in the test cell, hopefully in a couple of months. Stay tuned for that. It's gonna be awesome on a beautiful day. Thanks for watching.